So, I did the math. There's only 20,900 days left in my life. So, I decided to make a bucket list of everything I want to do before I kick the bucket. I've never done this before, and this took way longer, than I thought it would, even though I only have four things. I guess there's just really not a whole lot I want out of life. This first one that I got there is really the only one that I knew right away. So, the perfect seven. So, number one is make the perfect seven. The perfect seven is what I call the seven games that I want to make no matter what. I have a million different ideas, but I'm pretty sh certain that I will literally die before I can make all of them, especially since I keep getting more, like, on a day-to-day basis. I don't think it's possible to make everything that I want to make. So, the perfect seven are one is a monster catching game. Pokemon's my favorite game. So naturally, I would want to make a game like Pokemon. The game that I have in mind is that you have three party members, and each of them gets equipped with a monster, so you have a total of six party members in battle. So it would be basically like, you would have your soldier or, your character, and you would fight alongside your monster. It wouldn't just be like, dog fighting each other, cockfights, like Pokemon, because I don't want to just make Pokemon. Because the thing is, if you just make Pokemon, then, there's really no reason to play your game. Just go play Pokemon. That's why Temtem sucks so much. So that's how I want to differentiate it, with it being basically, just like a regular, JRPG, except you can have a monster like equipped to you, like just any other piece of equipment. I have two sequels that I've already thought of for this series, and I think it would end. It would just be a trilogy. I can't really think of anything that would happen after that, but who knows? And number two is an MMO. I really want to make an MMO because I really like MMOs. And the MMO that I want to make is like a classic JRPG style combat, like turn-based combat, like, Final Fantasy VI, Bravely Default. Bravely Default is actually, playing that game is what got me the idea to just be like, what if this was an MMO? Dragon Quest, basically those style of games, but in an MMO setting. It doesn't, there really isn't anything like it. think the off the top of my head, the closest thing that exists is Dragon Quest X, which number one was never translated into English, and number two, it's not really turn-based. It's from what I've seen, it uses more of like an ATB style system where, you got a meter that charges up and then you attack when that meter is full. And then number three is Dinosaur RPG. So I love dinosaurs, and I love JRPGs, and I love video games. So basically, this is a way that I would wanna like combine my two passions into one and make it dinosaur, make it like a JRPG, just like a regular JRPG, but taking place in the Mesozoic era where and all the characters are dinosaurs. If anything I make would be like a big, never-ending series like Final Fantasy or Dragon Quest, I would want it to be this. I would want, to be kind of like, oh yeah, that's the dinosaur RPG guy. I want to be that guy. I want to be the dinosaur RPG guy. I want that to be my identity. And then number four is, I call it Wandering. Basically, it's an action RPG. You guys, you notice I like RPGs, huh? Can you tell? It's basically, it's kind of like a silly game. Not really a silly game. It's an action RPG where you go from one side of the world to the other side of the world. And, of course, a bunch of stuff happens in between. But that's the main objective. The story is like, you get fired from your job and you can't pay, your house's mortgage, so you just look at your map and you're like, ah, the city of Elisa, that's the farthest place away from here. I'm just gonna go there. So you go on this big. Oh, good night.
You staying up late?
No, I'm not planning to.
Okay, you've loved too much love for me.
Eh.
Your brother is sleeping on the couch. I tried for three times to wake him up and he didn't.
Yeah, I thought about waking him up too, but I just thought, he'll get more sleep this way.
Yeah, okay. Well, I left the light in the hallway on for you. When you go up, you can turn it off.
Oh, okay. So basically, where was I? Oh yeah. So you would go from you'd go on this big adventure to just go to Elisa. And I kind of really like want it to have kind of like a Lord of the Rings or the Hobbit vibe. I don't want you to be like this big hero that saves the world or anything. I just want you to be a traveler that goes on a journey. And I will also want the main character to have like a very sarcastic sense of humor. Like he or she, because I think would be, the most fun if you get to like make your own character. I think he or she would just be just done with everyone's shit all the time. I think that would be really funny. And everything you do, whether it's combat or non-combat, like crafting or gathering items, I want that to get you experience points because I want stats to be not just related to combat. I want it to be like You know, kind of like RuneScape, you know, like wood cutting and mining, you know, all your various crafting skills. I want agility to be a skill so you can, like, you know, if that's high enough, you don't have to, like, you can, like, take shortcuts, you don't have to, like, go the long way. That's the kind of game that I want it to be. And I want it to be an action RPG, because number one, there will be like a party system, but it'll be like, you know, just like guest allies that like show up throughout the story sometimes. And eventually I want you to be able to like build your own little mini army of these guys. And that will all come together in the climax of the game. But for the most part, you will be alone. And a turn-based RPG with only one playable character isn't very fun. And also, I want you to feel alive. Like, I want you to feel like the world is alive. Like it reacts to you, not just like, you know, you walked into an enemy and then it's like you get transported into you know, the battle area. I want it to be like RuneScape, but like actually fun. Okay, so this is where, these are like the first four up here. These are the ones that every time I think of the Perfect Seven, this is what I always come to. And now my mind kind of like draws a bit of a blank. So, I'm a big fan of Dragon Ball. It's one of my favorite things ever. So I wanted to make a game that's like a shonen anime, like Dragon Ball. So you know, you've got all your various tropes and all that. And the way that I kind of figured it out how the gameplay would work, and I really like this, is that it's action based. The combat's action based. And you know, you've got each ability mapped to a button, but over in the corner, like over time, you'll have a bar fills up, and when it's full, you'll be able to do something called an inner monologue that allows you to change up your skills and map them to different buttons. This allows you to have the fast action of shonen, while also having like 1,000 moves that you can do, because you know, shonen anime, they've got like a million special moves, but the action is very fast, so that's basically how I think it would work. Like, you know, those moments where everything just kind of pauses and the character just kind of like thinks to themselves and goes over the strategy. That's what I think the inner monologue would be. So that's what you do to change your abilities, mid-battle. And then next, what would I want it to be next? So I wanted to do something that was kind of like a musical. Like there, you know, there's a musical in every form of media, you know, TV shows, movies. But there's never been a game that was a musical. And then Tokyo Mirage Sessions came out, and then this idea kind of went on the back burner. But this is still a story that I wanna. Oh yeah, and Epic Mickey 2, that was a musical as well. But this is still kind of like a story that I want to tell, even if it's not, you know, a new concept. So I don't know if I would put that in my perfect 7, but that is something that I still want to do someday. So instead, Jadestone. Jadestone is a 14-part story. Made up of very, very many different stories that I wrote in high school. Is basically the Christian cinematic universe, where it's all these bunch of seemingly unrelated stories until the final part where they all like come together. The first part is actually 7 parts long, so it's a 7-part story, but since the first part 1 is 7 is basically 7 different parts, 7 different arcs, it's pretty much a 14-part story. So this is a very ambitious kind of thing. But so I kind of want think that like give it like the Kingdom Hearts approach, where like, you know, you have all those little different worlds with their own like little self-contained stories within them. Of course, the difference being, you know, you have a whole different cast of playable characters in each world, instead of, you know, it just being Sora, Donald, and Goofy the whole time. So it would basically be like 7 different games, 7 different smaller games in one big game. The way I imagine it would work is that it would work kind of like Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance, where it's action based, but you have like all your abilities mapped to like one button, and it just kind of like cycles through them, you know, as you press that button, and you can like use the D-pad to cycle through them if there's a specific ability you want to use. That's how I kind of imagine it would work. And then for the 7th one, there is another MMO I want to make, where it's like there's just nothing when the game launches. And it's like you have to like come together and like invent stuff with the other players and like basically build a civilization with all the other players, and it would be basically a game that evolves itself over time, a game that the players kind of create, and it would have like its own like history, like a player driven history. And I pitched that to one of my friends in college, and they said, you know, they don't think that would really work out. That would be more of like a fun game for people who want to become game developers, rather than, you know, a game that people would actually play for fun. And that is still something that I want to make. I think that could be a really fun and interesting concept, where you just, you know, there's nothing in the world, and then, you know, you make tools, and then you build cities, and it just kind of progresses like a civilization, but I don't think I should put 2 MMOs in my perfect 7. I think I would be lucky if I get to make 1 MMO, and hopefully that will be successful and will not just shut down. Because that would be heartbreaking. I don't know how I'd cope with something like that. What would I want my 7th one to be? In every list, when I get down to the last one, it's always a hard decision, especially when you try to think of it on the spot. I wanted to make like a mecha RPG, but I never really like fleshed it out, so I guess that wouldn't be like in my perfect seven. I got it. Ben Drake. Van Drake Van Damme is a strategy RPG series that I wanted to make. Basically, you are paranormal investigator Van Drake Van Damme, and you go on a bunch of different adventures, uncovering the mysteries of the world. I believe I came up with like five different stories for Van Drake Van Damme, but my favorite is about the Mothman. Yeah, and I think that's. Although I don't think every Van Drake Van Damme would be like within the same genre. I think, some of them would be different genres. And the reason for that is, some Van Drake Van Damme stories that I've read in, kind of don't have like a large cast of characters. And the thing about a strategy RPG is that you have a large cast of characters to have units to control. So I think not every Van Drake Van Damme game would be a strategy RPG. Maybe some would be like platformers. But yeah. That's kind of something I want to do, kind of like a mystery series, like a paranormal investigation, kind of like my own little like detective series, but with like a paranormal, supernatural kind of theme to it. So yeah, that's my perfect seven. These are the seven games that I want to make no matter what. And hopefully someday I will be able to achieve that. So number two on my bucket list, I want to visit Iga. So Iga is basically, historically the ninja capital of Japan. This was originally Obtain Waifu, but that requires the cooperation of someone else to want to marry me, and that's not really something I can accomplish with enough hard work. So then I decided that number two would be become a ninja. And then I kind of thought, I heard that in Iga there are classes that you can take to teach you the ways of the ninja, but I don't know if that's actually like true or it's just kind of like rumor. So instead I went to just visit Iga and take in all the historical and cultural goodness. All the ninja goodness that's there. I think it would be a really fascinating experience. Number three, this is where things just kinda go into like a take it or leave it kind of zone. So become the VGC world champion. I do VGC. It's the game that I play, quote unquote, professionally. It's Pokemon. So the reason why this is like take or leave is because, I mean, it's a video game. It doesn't really matter in the grand scheme of things. But, you know, it would be nice to win worlds. I think that would be really cool. And, you know, it would be cool to say that I'm the best at something and have it be, like, objective fact. Because I'm not good at a lot of things. There's not a whole lot of things I'm good at, but I know I'm good at this. No matter how trivial it may be, I want to say that I'm the best. So I want to become the best. Like no one ever was. And then number four is go to space. I think that would be an incredible experience. It would be so cool, but like, I have a panic attack just getting into an airplane. I think getting into a rocket would kill me. So this is kind of like, you know, if I can do it, maybe when I'm like 80 and technology has advanced to the point where it's like the super safe, then maybe, yeah, I'll go to space. That would be super cool. But until then, you know, there's still a matter of conquering my fears and, yeah, so that's why it's take it or leave it. Would be, like, on paper, sounds so cool. But in practice, I think I would be scared to my wit's end. But it would be awesome. And, you know, just like that, that's my bucket list. That's everything I want to do before I die, which isn't a lot. I do want to run for president, but that's more like a something to just do for fun of it. I don't actually want to become president, but I just think it would be fun to like, hey, what if I win? What's going to happen then? I think that would just be a funny thing to do. And if I do become president, I can say that I finally accomplished something. But that's not something that I would want to put on a bucket list. That would just be something that I'd just be like, hey, yeah, okay, I'll do it. I think 2032 is when I'll do that, and then maybe I'll do go again 2036, and then maybe one more time 2042. I don't know if that lines up well. 2044, just because I like that number. I think that would be neat. But yeah, when it actually came down to it, I thought I knew exactly what I wanted to put down. But I actually sat here for like 2 hours just trying to think, okay, perfect seven. Go to Iga. Now what? Win VGC, I guess. And it's like, this is not the first time I thought of a bucket list. I think years ago I came up with four other things. And it was, number three was visit Japan. Number four was become a ninja. Number one was the perfect seven, but for the life of me, I could not remember what number two was, so I think it was go to space, but I'm not sure. Maybe it'll come to me someday, maybe it won't. If I can't think of it, then I guess it wasn't really that important to me anyway. Or perhaps it was going to space all along. Or maybe it was get a black belt, because I never finished my karate training. I quit, you know, to pursue school, And then I just kind of like never got back into it, even though I wanted to. So maybe finishing that was number two. Maybe I'd want to replace Go to Space with that. Because Go to Space is something that, like, yeah, I want to do it, but like, I think I know I would chicken out and not ever do it, even if I had the opportunity. So maybe, you know. But I think the reason why I didn't include that is because Go to Iga and Become a Ninja are kind of like overlap with it a bit. You know, I combined Become a Ninja and Visit Japan into one with Go to Iga, so maybe that's what I did there. Well, it'll remain a mystery forever. I'm your Christian, and this has been the Auditory Journal of a Boring Man. Oh yeah, and it's 4 in the morning. Amazing. You know that one scene from Shrek Super Slam where Quasimodo's banging out on his bells, and then Shrek comes up and he says, "I don't want to be rude, but it's 4 in the morning."